And what I think is happening now is that the prices are simply coiling. You know, the spring is getting tighter and tighter on gold and silver now, just like it was back in 1974, 1975, and 1976, because we're surrounded by simply too many catalysts that any one of which could ignite this market. What is happening now has actually happened before with gold and silver. It happened in 2006. Prices were completely flat, went nowhere in the middle of what ended up being a clear bull market. And if someone had gotten discouraged and sold then, they would have missed out on some very big gains. But the real big comparison is from 1974 to 1976. If you look at the gold and silver prices then, they fell by over 40%, almost half, over a two-year period of time. And yet, what was going on at that time? We had high inflation, inflation that's higher than even now, high unemployment. We were in a recession. We had political concerns, geopolitical concerns. And probably one of the biggest catalysts at the time that gold analysts looked at was the fact that for the first time in over 40 years, you could buy gold again as a US citizen. So a lot of gold analysts assumed that, well, that demand is going to, that pent up demand, now that it's legal, is gonna push gold up and silver will probably follow it, right? And yet what happened? They did just the opposite. Not only were they not flat, they actually fell, and fell dramatically in over a two-year period of time. Again, they were surrounded by catalysts just like now. When you look at the commodity complex, I don't include gold and silver in that. Now, silver does have some a large industrial component, a growing industrial component, but for the most part, I do believe that the mainstream views gold and silver as monetary metals, not commodities. And so, do I need to buy monetary metals right now? I think that's what a lot of institutional investors are asking themselves. And I think the answer to that is no, they don't think they need to buy them right now. Partly because the stock market is still going up. So they're gonna dance to that music as long as it keeps playing. Commodities have been up tremendously over the past year, year and a half, whatever it's been. And gold and silver in 2021 have been nothing but weak, flat to down. So it's a fair question. I think there's a couple answers to that. Why do I need to buy monetary metals? Why do I need to buy gold and silver if inflation is only going to last for 2 or 3 months? I don't see the institutional world, which is where the big capital would come in and push gold and silver demand and thus prices a lot higher. I don't see them coming over until those things shift. I think it's inevitable that they do, and I do think inflation will not be transitory. But until they feel compelled to come over, until they feel the need to buy a monetary metal for monetary or financial reasons, they may not come back over into the gold and silver market. So I think that's one explanation of what may be going on. And so I just, because I have that big picture view, I've been using this opportunity to actually just continue to accumulate both gold and silver and the miners. You know, again, we've been here before, so I don't want people to get discouraged, because we've seen this before. It's happened before, and I think the spring is just getting tighter and tighter and tighter. In the immediate term, treasury yields have been spiking, and the US dollar has been rising, inversely correlated to gold normally and silver. And so that does partly explain what's happening, at least right now. But again, it comes down to the fallout, the real world effects of all those things that's going to drive the people that don't see what we see into this market, in my view. And the demand will push prices higher. Again, I wish it didn't have to be a crisis, but how do we escape that at this point? I'm always trying to think, okay, what assumption do I have that could be wrong? I'm expecting a crisis, and that gold and silver will respond to that. Well, how does that not happen? And I haven't come up with a good answer yet. Which means I think my assumption is correct, that at some point we're going to have a monetary event. Mike Maloney has spent a lot of time talking about this, and that will definitely impact gold and silver, just like it did back in the 1970s, just like it did in 2006, 2007, that at some point something, some type of monetary crisis is probably going to happen, because you can't there is no free lunch. You can't be negligent to the extent that central bankers and politicians are today and not have any type of fallout or consequences. We had the same thing again back in the 1970s, and eventually reality caught up to, you know, what was going on at the time, the circumstances. So I think, you know, at some point, this is going to happen for us. The system is unsustainable. It can't last forever. They see the case for gold and silver, but they have to be in the stock market, because even a hedge fund, they're filing quarterly returns, quarterly reports, right? Just like a company, they have to show performance. They have to show that they're doing well, right? And so they're going to go where the money can be made at that time, you know? But what really struck me was how scary the exit could be. They're all into the stock market. They really are. And that hasn't really changed all that much, as evidenced by the stock market continuing to rise, right? They're all there. It really is a movie theater. Every seat is taken, and the exit door is one little door off to the side, and they're all going to try to get out that door at the same time. That's what concerns me, is that it won't be a normal correction in the stock market, that it could be just another outright crash. And if it is a crash, if it's just a waterfall sell-off, gold and silver would be impacted in that, because it becomes a liquidity event then, and they, you know, sell whatever they can sell, or the brokers do it for them. They automatically sell assets to cover, you know, losing ones, which could be gold and silver. So if it is a waterfall crash, I'm a little concerned that gold and silver would fall as well. But just like in was it October of 2008 or March of 2020, those events are quick and abrupt for gold and silver typically, and that would be perhaps last train out. So we'll see, but I would rather see a correction than a crash, but I fear the crash. If there's not a crash in the stock markets and it's merely a correction, consider the fact that gold and silver are already down. They've already fallen. They're down, both down over 20%. So if there's not a crash in the stock market, it's merely a correction, the value is clearly going to be seen in gold and silver, and they may not correct anymore. They already have. They could turn and begin to rise again. So that's another scenario that could play out. We don't know exactly how it's going to play out, right? But if that scenario plays out, you may not get another buying opportunity. You may have to buy when they're rising. And by the way, you might have to pay a higher premium then as well, because as demand goes up, premiums predictably also rise. The dilemma that every investor who waits is going to face. Okay, do I buy now? Oh, wait, do I buy now? Oh, do I buy now? What about now? Do I wait? That's the question that's going to go through your mind all the time. And so, pardon me, because I see gold and silver as money, I think if you see them as money and not just an investment, that kind of answers part of the question for you. Just accumulate them on weakness. Just continue to buy weakness. That's the strategy I've taken. And on big sell-offs, I tend to buy even more. So that's I'm accumulating for the big picture, what I see taking place over the next 2, 3, 4 years, however long it plays out. So that's how I handle it.